In this problem, we will see series RLC network source free. Okay, source free series RLC network. So here question is determine I of t. So I of t is the current flowing through this inductance. So you have to determine expression for I of t. And there is a current source. Its value is 1 u of minus t. So that means this source is active only for t less than 0. When t is greater than 0, this current source is deactivated, that is 0. It is removed from the circuit. So the circuit is source free series RLC network. Okay. So step 1, that is we will write for t less than 0. So t less than 0, the current source is active and so this current source is active so this value is 1 ampere. And this value is 40 micro and this is 0.5 and this is 100 and current flowing through this is I, this is VC. Okay, for t greater than 0, for t greater than 0, this current source will not come into picture. So it is nothing but merely a series RLC. So series RLC. So this is 100 and this is 0.5 and this is 40 micro. Okay. And voltage across capacitor is VC and current passing through this is I. Okay. So this is for t greater than 0. Now in the step 1, we will find first we will identify whether it is series RLC or parallel RLC. So that can be done by how? By removing the or by deactivating the independent source. Here deactivate means it should be 0, that will be open, and the remaining circuit will be, it is a series RLC. So it is series RLC. Now you have to find out alpha value. Alpha value is equation is R by 2L, and if you substitute you will get 100 per second. Okay. And omega naught value if you calculate it is 1 by root LC. If you substitute and simplify you will get 224. 224 value you will get. So that means omega naught is greater than alpha, the response will be underdamped response. Okay. So for that we have to find one more term, that is omega d, that is omega naught square minus alpha square under the square root. So if you substitute you will get 200.4, so we will approximate it to 200. Okay, 200. Okay, radian per second. So this is a step 1. Step 2, we have to find initial current and voltage. So that is for t equal to 0 minus, that is this circuit, in this at t equal to 0 minus this will act like a short and capacitor act like an open circuit. So remaining in this circuit is, this part will not be there and this is short circuit, and 1 ampere current. So what is I? I is nothing but 1 ampere here. So we can directly write that I of 0 minus is nothing but 1 ampere. It is directly the current source. And what about the voltage across the capacitor? At t equal to 0 plus, this is open circuit. So open circuit voltage will be what? It is nothing but the voltage across the resistor. Since inductor is a short circuit, voltage across resistor is nothing but voltage across capacitor. So that is nothing but current into resistance, 100 ohm and 1 ampere. So it will be 100 volt. So VC of 0 minus is 100 into 1, it is 100 volt. So it is 100 volt. So once we know this one, we can tell I of 0 plus is nothing but I of 0 minus, it is inductor current, and VC of 0 plus is VC of 0 minus, and it is 100 volt. Okay, that is step 2. Now step 3, response. Since it is underdamped, since you are going to get underdamped response here, so form equal solution will have this form, that is I of t is equal to e power minus alpha t into b1 cos omega dt plus b2 sin omega dt. Okay, and we already know I of 0, that is nothing but 1, and if you substitute t equal to 0 in this case, e power 0 1, b1 cos 0 is b1, b2 sin 0 is 0, so it is nothing but b1. So b1 value we calculated now. Okay, so b1 value we have calculated. Now one more equation we want, that is step 4 we will write. So one more equation we need to determine b2. So how we can do? I of t we know, so better you do di by dt and equate t equal to 0, that will be equal to vl of t divided by l. So since when we have vc expression, we will differentiate, we will get dvc by dt, that one we will equal to ic of t by c. But when we get I of t or il of t, current through the inductor when you are calculating, if you differentiate di by dt, you will get vl divided by l. So voltage across inductor is l into di by dt. Okay, so this if you differentiate and equate t equal to 0, so that you substitute here, first you differentiate, then you substitute t equal to 0, what you get, it is b2 omega d minus alpha b1. Just you verify, you would first differentiate and equate t equal to 0, you will get this expression. You just verify this one, you will get exactly this equation. Okay, once we have that equation, we will equate this term di of t by dt, t equal to 0 plus, that we will equate vl of 0 plus divided by l. So it is nothing but the current voltage relationship of a inductor. Okay, so this one, so we should know now what is vl of 0 plus. So vl of 0 plus is required now. So we'll again write that circuit. So we have inductor and resistor here and capacitor here. So this is R, this is L. So I think better I will write the value of R. R value is 100 and current is this direction I and 0.5 Henry this one, and this is VL. And another one is VC, this is VC, and VC capacitance value is 40 micro. Okay, so if you apply KVL like this, if you apply KVL, you can take clockwise or anti-clockwise. Let me take a clockwise and we will write the equation KVL for this one. Now we are calculating at t equal to 0 plus instant. So it is first one is the I have to travel in this in the clockwise direction. So if you go through in the clockwise direction, first one you are getting VL and we are getting minus sign, so that is minus VL of 0 plus. Next one is the current So this current is nothing but opposite to this I, so it is nothing but minus, it is minus I of 0 plus into 100, okay, and this one you are getting plus VC, VC of 0 plus equal to 0. So this is if you take clockwise. If you take anti-clockwise, then first voltage will be VC here, that will be minus VC, and this will be this current, if you take clockwise, it will be in the direction of I, so it will be 100 into I of 0 plus and plus VL of 0 minus, and simply we are going to multiply this one minus 1. So but what we are interested is VL of 0 plus we are interested, so this you take to the other side, so then remaining is VC of 0 plus minus VR of 0 plus, that is minus I of 0 plus into 100. So we know both this VC and I of. What is the VC of 0 plus? VC of 0 plus is we have calculated VC of 0 plus is 100, and that is 1 ampere. So we will write 100 minus VL of 0 plus, that is one more is I of 0 minus I of 0 plus, I of 0 plus is 1 into 100, okay. So that is nothing but 0 you are going to get. So di by dt evaluated at equal to 0 plus is VL of 0 plus divided by L, but that is nothing but 0 you are getting. But what is this equation? This equation is, you have just see here, B2 omega d minus alpha d. So B2 value we have to calculate. Omega d we know, that is 200 minus alpha into B1. Alpha is 100, B1 is 1, that we have calculated before. So this value is equal to 0. So B2 value what you get is 0.5 you are going to get. So if you substitute this one in the main equation, so I of t is e power minus alpha, alpha is 100 t into B1 is 1 cos 200 t plus 0.5 into sin 200 t. Okay, so this is the solution.